Welcome to another one of our videos. Today is going to be the rear brake pad change on my W221 S550. Not doing the rotors on this one and the rear. Even though I did the front ones, the rear ones were recently replaced. So these ones are good to go. And the pads also were actually recently replaced as well. But with, if you watch my front brake video, Mercedes OEM pads, which dust like crazy. So I'm replacing them with Akebono pads. The ones that I'm using are EUR 986. Depending on your car's configuration, those may or may not be different. I believe all of the standard non-AMG S classes do use these pads, including the AMG sport cars, but your actual AMG cars, your S63 and S65, I believe use different rear calipers and different rear pads as well. So, I got a little bit ahead of myself in the video, took the wheel off already, jacked the car up obviously. I had a seized lug stud or wheel bolt, so I ended up having to get that out. So I did that off camera and before I started the video. So at this point, I have the wheel off, have the car jacked up, of course. Jacked up by the rear differential and then put stands underneath the rear lift points. So everything is nice and stable. When you're jacking up the rear of one of these cars, you definitely want to chalk the front wheels very well. I chalked both front wheels, front and back, 4 chalks total, to make sure it doesn't roll around anywhere because you don't have a parking brake in the front, of course. So that will pose an issue for sure. So everything's ready to go. And the first step in doing this is going to be removing the clip on the outside and removing the caliper, floating caliper in the back, and pulling the pads out. So I'm going to go ahead and get the camera up closer on the caliper itself and show you where to go from here. All right, so the first step in removing the caliper and therefore the pads is removing this outer clip right here. In order to do that, you need to take a screwdriver or a pry bar, something to pry with, stick it in the hole of the caliper right there, and pry the clip back towards the back of the car and out of the hole. So this one is unlatched. You probably can't see it on camera, but you can see it in person. There's a little hook. Now that those are loose, the clip should be able to just pull right off. And you can see the little hook that I was talking about right there. Kind of hooks into the hole and forward. So, clip's off. Next step's gonna be pulling off the caliper. In order to do that, you're gonna need some 7mm hex sockets. I'll show you what that looks like in a second. And we're going to come in from the backside. Again, I'm going to reposition the camera and show you that better. Alrighty, so in order to get the caliper off, there's two of these guys. There's one right here that you can see, and there's one down underneath that looks exactly the same that you can't get the camera down there and really film that very well. So I'm going to show you how to do the process on the top, and you're just going to repeat on the bottom. So what you need to do is take off little dust caps that are on here. You can use a screwdriver, or might just be able to get them off by hand to pop those off. They look just like that when they come off. And then right inside that rubber housing, there's a 7mm hex bolt. Socket just slides in through there, and you're gonna come in with a ratchet behind that and loosen it. I'm gonna loosen it off camera because the camera's in my way, but that is the basic loosening and access procedure for that. So once I've got everything loose and the caliper ready to come off, I'm gonna show you what to do next. Alrighty, so I have the bolts loosened on the back. Caliper's loose and ready to come out. Essentially, all you need to do that is, at this point, once the bolts are loose, pull it off and out. Now, you're gonna need to put this thing somewhere. You don't wanna just let it hang by the brake line and by the sensor wire that's there. So, what I like to do is tie the caliper up using a bungee cord to something like the sway bar. This caliper is pretty darn light, so it's not gonna pull a whole bunch on the bungee cord. And that caliper is kind of out of the way. At this point, you're able to pull this brake pad off super easily. Literally just kind of just comes out. So that brake pad is done. And the pad in here is the one with the sensor on it. I believe only one side on the rear has the sensors. So and all you need to do to pull that out is unplug the wire from the sensor connector on the caliper there, which I believe you can see. There you go, the caliper sensor back there. And this caliper goes into the piston. So to pull it out, you just need to grab it and pull it towards you. And you can see it's got a clip to clip it into the piston. So at this point, we're ready to put the new pads in. Now I'm gonna use a new sensor with my new pads. The new sensors that I have are angled correctly for this type of pad in this setup. So I'm gonna go ahead and use those. And then I'm going to put everything back together. So once I get a new pad in there, I will come back and get you up to date on what's been done. All right, so I have both pads greased up now with Moly brake lube, ready to go back and get reinstalled. To do that, it's relatively simple. Got the new pad right there. Line it up with the caliper piston. Push that into place. Might be easier said than done with fresh clips, but there we go. So that's ready to go. And then the other pad simply needs to slot in place right there. So, in order to reinstall, all we need to do is take the bungee cord loose off of the sway bar, drop that on the ground, and we should be able to slip this all back into place. Now, as expected, I thought I might run into this issue, and I did. I need to push the caliper piston back. So, in order to do that, you can do a couple different things. You can use a C-clamp. That's one way of doing it. What I'm going to do is, I think, get out a special caliper tool that I have. A caliper piston pushback tool is what it's called. And push back the piston with that. The reason you need to do that is because the old brake pads wore down, so the piston is sitting in a further out natural position or stationary position. And so in order to get the new pads in and get it all around the rotor and everything, you need to push that piston back to accommodate for the thicker new pads. So I'm going to go ahead, take the pads back off, get the tool out, and we'll go from there. Okay, so I have my brake pad spreading, or brake caliper piston pushback tool. I think people also call it a pad spreader. Have that tool out here in the caliper, ready to go. So essentially the way that this thing works, it's a ratcheting spreader. So as you crank and ratchet this thing back and forth, it opens up these two blocks that almost look like a brake pad themselves, and it will push the caliper's piston back. So to do this one, you can see it's loose in there right now. Ratchet, 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 ratchet. And it's just pushing that piston back. Stops right there, so you can switch it the other way. Ratchet's closed. Piston's pushed all the way back. Done deal. Easy as that. Nice to have the proper tool for the job. So, now we can install the brake pads. I'll do that off camera because I showed you in the previous clip how to do that. Snap in the back one, slip in the front one, and the caliper will just slide into place over. So, should be easy peasy. I'll come back once the caliper slid over the pads. Pads are back in. Everything's ready to roll. Essentially, all I gotta do is take that caliper, slide it over the brake pads, and then what I'm gonna do is just find the holes where the bolts go and just kind of push them into place because it helps hold the caliper in place. The reason I'm doing that, before I tighten everything down, I want to install the brake pad sensor. Normally you do that with the brake pad out of the car. It's already installed. So if you forgot that and you tighten everything down, you can still do it without too much of an issue. I'll show you on a pad outside of the vehicle how it works. Essentially, on the pad, you have this little area up here. You have your sensor. What I like to do is twist the wires of the sensor together in order to give it a little bit better strain relief and bend radius. And then you just pop this down into place on the pad. It just slips down into that crevice in there. So I'm going to go ahead and do that off camera for this one. All you got to do is reach in through here and just push it down, done deal. And I will come back, talk about the wrap-up process and how to finalize the brake job. I have the bolts tightened back up on the back. Dust caps, don't forget those. They go right into those little rubber housings. And they take a little bit of force to press in, so don't be shy with that. Getting those guys set into place. Especially that bottom one, really doesn't want to go in. I'll take care of that off camera and finish that up. The last little bit to the brake job is putting the clip back on the front. That guy just goes like so, and then as it slides all over the place. Once you get it positioned somewhat correctly, you get those, you kind of push towards the back, get those guys started in the holes, and then pushed into place. You can double check that everything's pushed into place by kind of poking around, making sure it's all happy. Looks like it is, and we're good to go. So, that's it. That's all you need to do for the rear brake pads. If you're doing the rotor, really the only extra step is taking this bracket off and then pulling the rotor off itself. T30 screw, rotor comes off, put the new one on, and put the bracket on, put the caliper and everything else back on as well. It's pretty darn straightforward. So, With that, I want to thank you all for watching. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions, and I hope to see you in the next video.